Always alone, never with a herd. Prettiest mare I've ever seen, you have to take my word. Up on Stony Ridge after this chestnut mare, been chasing her for weeks. Well, I'd catch a glimpse of her every once in a while, taking her meal, bathing. Fine lady. This one day I happened to be real close to her and I saw her standing over there, so I snuck up on her nice and easy, got my rope out, and I flung it in the air. I'm gonna catch that horse if I can, and when I do, I'll give her my brand, and we'll be friends for life. She'll be just like a wife. I'm going to catch that horse if I can. I got her, and I'm pulling on her, and she's pulling back like this mule going up a ladder. And I take a choice, and I jump right up on her. Damned if I don't land right on top of her. And she takes off, running up onto the ridge, higher than I've ever been before. She's running along just fine, till she stops, and something spooked her. The sidewinder all coiled and ready to strike. She doesn't know what to do for a second, but then she jumps off the edge, me holding on. Above the hills, higher than eagles, were gliding, suspended in the sky. Sun, we were riding, my eyes were filled with light. Behind us, black walls, below us, a bottomless canyon, floating with no sound. Ghosts far below seem to be suddenly rising, exploding all around. I'm going to catch that horse if I can, and when I do, I'll give her my friend, and we'll be friends for life. She'll be just like a a mile down that sea. I look down and I see this red thing below us coming up real fast, and it's our reflection, this little pool of water about 6 feet wide and 1 foot deep. And we're crawling down right through it. We hit and we splashed it dry. That's when I lost my hold and she got away. But I'm gonna try to get her again someday.